First digital Christmas concert.
We know how hard this year has been for everybody, so the students and performing arts team here at Wilmslow High School have been determined to not let this Christmas pass without some form of celebration.
We are delighted to welcome our audience tonight via YouTube, and we say a big hello to all our usual Christmas carol concert goers. We hope you will enjoy our range of ensembles, solos, duets, readings and much, much more, and we cannot wait until next year when we can all be together again.
So sit back, pour yourself a Christmas drink, and enjoy our festive concert.
So from everyone here at Wilmslow High School, a very happy Christmas and best wishes for the new year.
You better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list, he's checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty or nice.
Thank you. It rode on the wave with the whole world before it, defying resistance it travelled so fast. And some spoke of freedom and vowed to ignore it, and some lost their lives as they lay in its grasp. Some stayed indoors and protected their safety, heard government slogans and tried to comply. Fragmented families dealt with it bravely, losing their loved ones without saying goodbye. It haunted the blows of the US election and challenged integrity closer to home, highlighting for all a profound disconnection, those who consider and those who condone. Some faced the danger of frontline contagion in surgeries, care homes, in hospital wards. With paltry equipment but true dedication, the claps from our doorsteps, their token reward. When future inquiries explain how it caught us, defining where blame or where praise really dwells, will they say with conviction, it finally taught us we do things for others and not just ourselves? Will they describe how we acted together, ensuring the lonely and jobless could cope, cautiously thinking that life could get better, winter of struggle, but springtime of hope? It rides on a wave with the whole world before it, defying resistance, it travels so fast, and some speak of freedom and vow to ignore it, and some lose their lives as they lie in its grasp.
Thank you. up a heart and you've torn it apart in about a week or so. Is it about time in the moments in my life when I should let you go? Or should I, oh, let you go? Or should I, oh, let you know? It's because you're taken, you're occupied, you're spending time with someone else, it's winter time. Your heart is taken and mine will be gone in time. It's a love story at Christmas time.
Thank you.
the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth and a town called Galilee to a virgin Mary. The angel told Mary, "Blessed are you, Mary, do not be afraid. You have found favour with God and will give birth to a son named Jesus. He will be Lord and on highest and King amongst all men."
Mary, a virgin, was troubled by this news. She didn't know how she would bear a child. An angel came and told her that you are with child, and anything is possible with the will of God.
Joseph, Mary's husband, also had an angel of the Lord appear to him. "Joseph, be not afraid. Take Mary as your wife and do not judge her, for she will have a child of the Holy Spirit. He will be called Emmanuel, which means God with us."
Caesar Augustus, the Roman emperor, said that every man and woman should take a census in their hometown to register for taxation.
Mary and Joseph returned to Bethlehem in Galilee, the place of their birth.
When they arrived, they found there was no room at the inn. As modest people, they had no means to go elsewhere. Mary, heavily pregnant with child, was given a stable in which to rest. This is where she gave birth to a beautiful baby boy amongst the sheep and the oxen.
Meanwhile, shepherds in a field nearby kept watch over their flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to these humble men. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring great news of joy for all people. A baby boy has been born today. He will be the saviour to all of earth and mankind. You will find the baby in the manger, wrapped in cloth." The shepherds went to Bethlehem to see the miracle baby, finding and adoring him. They were amazed and spread good news, glorification and praise for God.
Three wise men, the Magi in the time of King Herod, travelled to Jerusalem. They had heard the good news that the King of the Jews had been born, as was foretold. The King Herod told the three wise men to go forth and search for the baby who had been born, the Son of God, so that he himself could worship him. The three wise men followed his wishes and followed the star that had appeared in Bethlehem, and they were overjoyed to find the baby Jesus. They worshipped him and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you. Before Christmas, went all through the house. Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hope that St. Nicholas would soon be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, with visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap, are just out of our brains for a long, doesn't it?
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash.
The moon on the breast of the new fawn slow gave a lustre of the midday to the objects below. When what to my wondering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
With a little old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, dash away, dash away, dash away all.
As leaves up before the wild hurricane fly, and they meet with an obstacle mount to the sky, so up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too.
And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof, the prancing and pouring of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning round, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and looked like a peddler just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples so merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow.
The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed, like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me the know I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filling all the stockings, then he turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod at the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight,
Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night!
Pie and we'll do some caroling. Christmas. My true love and I had a fight, and so I chopped the pear tree down and burnt it just for spite. Then with a single cartridge I shot that blasted partridge. My true love, my true love, my true love gave to me. The second day after Christmas I pulled on the old rubber gloves, then very gently wrung the necks of both the turtle doves. My true love, my true love, my true love gave to me. The seventh day after Christmas my mother caught the croup. I had to use the three French hens to make some chicken soup. The four calling birds were a big mistake, for their language was obscene. The five golden rings were completely fake, and they turned my fingers green. The sixth day after Christmas the six laying geese wouldn't lay. I gave the whole darn gaggle to the RSPCA. The seventh day, what a mess I found! All seven of the swimming swans had drowned. My true love, my true love, my true love gave to me. The eighth day after Christmas, before they could suspect, I bundled up the eight maids a-milking, nine pipers piping, 10 ladies dancing, 11 lords a-leaping, 12 drummers drumming. Well, actually, I kept one of the drummers and sent them back collect. I wrote my true love, we are through love, and I said in so many words, furthermore, your Christmas gifts were for the birds.
Ha ha! Joining us in our 2020 Christmas concert. This event has joined so many others in being redesigned to take place in a virtual way, and we hope that has brought a little bit of the Christmas spirit to you wherever you are watching this. I think that there are four themes from the Christmas story that could be seen in this concert. Firstly, the strength to be found in community. Secondly, the importance of family. Thirdly, the power of light. And fourthly, the joy of gifts given and received. The first Christmas was a community occasion. It took place in a loaned and shared space, the stable of the inn. There were visitors drawn from neighbouring fields, the shepherds, and from distant lands, the three kings or the magi. And a community occasion is how we see our Christmas concert. One of the important occasions in the year when normally we welcome families, friends, former students, and members of our local community into this space, our school hall, a space we are delighted to share with you. Of course, this year, unfortunately, you cannot come and join us here. So instead, in various ways, we're trying to come out to you so we can share some of our community spirit wherever you are. The first Christmas was obviously a family occasion as Mary and Joseph welcomed their firstborn child into the world. And our young people performing during this concert have so much to thank their parents for, as their musical talents will have been nurtured and supported in so many ways by their families over the years. So we, who have enjoyed the performances in this concert, join our young people in thanking you, their families, for all that you do. For those of us who live in the northern hemisphere of our planet, Christmas always occurs in midwinter, when the hours of darkness are much longer and the weather much colder and wetter. But into this darkness, the Christmas season brings light. That light might be the light of the star that shined brightly over Bethlehem in the Christmas story. Or it might be the light given off by fireplaces like this one. Or it might be the wonderful range of Christmas lights that families and organisations put up and share freely with all who visit or pass by. Whatever the source of light, it is a powerful symbol of welcome and reassurance. And when light is shared, it is a gift that is given and received. So, just as the Christmas story is full of gifts, the gift of a newborn child, the gift of the Magi, the gift of love for the world and its people, so we like to think of our Christmas concert as a gift to our local community. Normally, we gather here to share lovely occasions with carols, coffee, and mince pies. This year, though, we will be sending these same gifts out into the local community with deliveries to local churches and residential homes, thanks to the kind generosity of the various businesses in the town. So from all the staff and students of Wilmslow High School, can I wish you a very merry and hope-filled Christmas, full of light and love. And we look forward to the new year and hope that we will be able to gather together in person at some point in 2021. Thank you.
Thank you.